Welcome back everyone to the channel. Today I think we're gonna try doing something that's based off of the other painting we did, the Winnie the Pooh one, with that kind of cool path or water stream thing fading into the distance, with it being like, you know, lighter in the background and darker, like, kind of like there's a clearing wherever the path goes. So I think I'm gonna do something like that, but I think I might just do something with bamboo in this. Maybe like a bamboo path or something. So let's get to it. All right, so first things first, we're starting off with this like sky blue color. Gonna fade it down with a little bit of white towards the bottom. But because most of this painting is gonna be covered in green, I don't really have to worry about doing so much of a background sky color. So it's just really simple. So here I'm just taking a 2-inch brush and just kind of dabbing in some of this like a spring green color, which, you know, just fading it down, bringing more in, and then eventually going to end up putting in this darker green in there for like all the darker foliage and shadows. So here is the start of the darker colors. It really adds more of just like the background, like I guess the word underpainting. So I'm just adding to the underpainting here. And obviously the central area is supposed to be lighter because that's where like there's a break in the bamboo and it's more of like a clearing, and that's where the path is gonna go. And the thing about a painting like this is it's actually really simple. Like, usually, I mean, like when I first started, this would have taken me a lot longer to do, but, you know, over the course of the last year and some change, I've learned to do it a little bit faster. Like, subtlety and reduction in how much time I'm spending just trying to do all the details really has helped me get faster. So what I did here is I just took this dark green color, kind of watered it down a little bit with some gray, a little bit of just a little tiny bit of white, not very much, just try to like fade it out more towards the background. Now I should have just done straight up that dark green color towards the foreground, which, you know, it doesn't really look that good in the end of it, other than, you know, I mean, you can tell what it is, but it doesn't really look perfect. So maybe I'll just go back and redo this one again some other point, or I'll just go back through this painting and just do a couple more closer bamboo stalks that actually have more definition than just this. Okay, so with the stalks mostly done, I just need to dab in a little bit of leaves and foliage with some of that lighter green and then the darker green to show some more shadows. And this is a really easy way of hiding the tops of the stalks. And also, when I take the tape off of it, you'll see me kind of hide the bottoms with, you know, some bushes and some grasses and, you know, whatever might be growing at the base of the little bamboo forest. So here you can see what I mean by when I dab in a little bit of this paint here, it kind of hides the bottom of the stalks and makes it look more like there's foliage down there, and also doesn't look as janky with just, you know, the bottoms of the bamboo stalks just kind of stopping there. So I debated on how I wanted to do this. I wasn't really sure how I wanted to do the path, so what I ended up doing is just painting in some like rails made out of like old dried bamboo, or at least that's the idea behind it, and then some some poles and then rails in. So here I'm just, it's just a mixture of like this beige color, a little bit of brown and gray. And this effect really helps with showing depth, where I'm starting from far away and getting wider or bigger or wider as it gets closer to the viewer. So if you're ever looking to try to find a way to make something look like it's got a lot of depth, this is a really easy way of doing it. I mean, it's all about perspective anyway, so if you can figure out how to do proper perspective, that helps, and everything looks more natural and a lot more real when you do that. So when I'm painting this, I was trying to figure out, like, if I was actually there, what would I see? Like, you're never gonna mow the lawn properly down like a path like this. So I imagine that there's gonna be a little bit of some grass sticking up around the bottoms of these poles, and then eventually just kind of where the sides of the path that isn't just dirt. So when painting in just like the ground, just start with the darkest color and then go to the lightest. That's how I do it. It makes it easiest. I mean, you could do it the other way around too. I mean, it really depends on you, how you want to do it. But for me, I always try to start with the darks and go to the lights. But in the case of like the background underpainting, I went with the lights, went to the darks. I guess it just depends on what part of a painting you're working on, your style, and just what works best for that particular item that you're painting. And I initially went into this not knowing how it was going to turn out, just because I'd never really painted anything like this before, other than the Winnie the Pooh painting, where it had like the stream going back and then going to like a little lighter area clearing in between the woods. So yeah, I didn't really know how this was going to work out, but I think it worked out enough for you to tell what it is, or what it was meant to be. And here I'm just adding some details back and forth with a little bit of a liner brush and some of that darker green color. It pays off to just paint in a little bit of like singular grass stems or stalks, whatever you want to call them. But it pays off in the end to make it look a little bit more 3D, a little bit more realistic, I think, to have more things standing out as they would be in reality. So with that, I will say thank you all for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe, comment, share all that. Helps me out, helps keep the wife happy, since these are all for her. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.